Okay, now let's try something different. How about four coins and four playing cards? And most of the effects, as you notice, are going to be with four coins and either four cards or four hands or two hands or whatever you want to call them. I'd like to show the situation as cleanly as I can at the beginning, and just like before, would you please look at the coins, make sure they're real, okay? Display them on the surface and place a card right under each one of the coins, just like so. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to cover these two, and of course these two. And what we're going to do is take a little journey. The coins are going to disappear and reappear one at a time. Where they go, nobody knows for sure. As an example, let's just say I wanted this coin to vanish. I'm going to pick it up and make it invisible for just a moment. You can't see it, neither can I. Let's just imagine it's right here in my hand. Now watch. I'm going to balance the coin onto the card and just make it disappear, just like that. Now I wonder where it could have gone. It might have gone into this card or this one or this one. Let's just see. No, it's not there. It's not there. Oh! I'll be darned. What a surprise. It's right here under this card. As you can see, the first coin has traveled. So let's try it again. We'll cover these two. And we'll take the coin just like this and place it in my hand. As you can see, it's invisible. In fact, here, let's just move it forward a little bit and pick it up and just flip it in the air, and it makes a flip and travels all the way across and joins these three coins over here. How would you like to try? Okay, now usually at this point I have the spectator come up, take the invisible coin, place it in the center of their hand. If you'll just pick up the card, sir, and they pick up the card, take the coin, balance it on the card, flip it in the air, it makes a flip and joins these over here.